Worldbuilding is the creation of fictional worlds through visual art, writing, or any other media. It can involve constructing histories, civilizations, laws, ecosystems, and more. It can be whatever you make it. For example, perhaps a regular fire cannot melt frost formed from a magic spell, but a dragon's fire can. Civilizations and ecosystems come with their own unique parameters as well. For a civilization, a creator may consider languages, social expectations, and infrastructure. And for ecosystems, they may think about different types of animals and how they live and interact in their habitats of the creator's world. History of world building. Worldbuilding has essentially existed as long as storytelling itself. When a character or story is conceptualized, an implied world around that subject comes to exist as well. But what really creates worldbuilding is the detail and the feeling the observer gets of a world extended beyond just the character and story. A prominent name in worldbuilding is J.R.R. Tolkien. Known for his 1937 book series The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings, his books include vast examples of worldbuilding. Middle-earth has various kingdoms, social structures, and races, all with different relationships with one another. Some, such as the elves, even have their own language written. Another take on worldbuilding is the 2009 movie Avatar, because of the inclusion of speculative biology, which I'll get more into later. Types of worldbuilding. Worldbuilding has infinite possibilities. A very popular form of worldbuilding is fantasy-based, where the author or artist creates many of their own rules for how the world works. I'd argue that a frequent trope of science fiction stories leans more into fictional rules set by the creator while using scientific terms, but not actually having a basis in science itself. Of course, there are countless ways to construct a fictional world, and there's no right way to do it. But I want to talk about what I'd consider science-based worldbuilding, in particular speculative biology. Speculative biology. Speculative biology is a genre of worldbuilding based around what kind of organisms could come to live and how they'd interact within their environment. It raises questions such as, what would life look like on another planet? Would it make sense for aliens to be humanoid? Or what would Earth be like if dinosaurs never went extinct? Examples of speculative biology. One example of a speculative biology project is C.M. Cosman and Simon Roy's World of Dinosauroids. Dinosauroids is a speculative biology world-building project by C.M. Cosman, author of works such as All Tomorrows and All Yesterdays, and artist and writer Simon Roy. The project breaks away from the ironically human-centric model of what if the dinosaurs had lived instead of humans. It doesn't simply put dinosaur skin on a human body. Dinosauroids are an intelligent, bird-like type of dinosaur based on troodontids. The project goes into the evolutionary purpose of traits the dinosauroids have and their own development of intelligence and tools, such as through their hunting techniques and the use of their beak alongside claws to construct and manipulate tools. The dinosauroids have different tribes and cultures. They create art and pass down stories to the younger generations. They also participate in wars against other dinosauroid tribes. The world of dinosauroids also explores what other types of animals could have evolved, like food sources, competition, companions, and predators. Speculative biology doesn't need to be limited to creatures we're already familiar with either. Concept artist and illustrator Alexander Ostrowski, for example, specializes in creating speculative biology designs of creatures, often in relation to sci-fi and fantasy. In conclusion, there are infinite possibilities when it comes to world building. The road is endless to where you can take a story or concept. It can be whatever you make it.